God sent his son. They call him Jesus. He came to love.
Let's grab our basic instructions before leaving Earth, and let's see what the Creator, Father God, has in store for us today. Hosea 7 and 8. So I'm going to read 7. When I would have healed Israel, then the iniquity of Ephraim was discovered, and the wickedness of Samaria. For they had committed falsehood, and the thief cometh in, and a troop of robbers spoileth without. And they consider not in their hearts that I remember all their wickedness. Now their own doing have beset them about. They are before my face. They make the king glad with their wickedness, and the princes with their lies. They are all adulterous as an oven heated by the baker, whose causes from rise after he hath kneaded the dough until he be leavened. In the day of our king, the prince have made him sick with a bottle of wine. He stretched out his hand with the scorners. For they have made ready their heart like an oven, while they lie in wait. Their baker sleepeth all the night. In the morning he burneth as a flame of fire. They are all hot as an oven. They have devoured their judges. All their kings are fallen. There is none among them that calleth unto me. Now I want you to look down here at the talking about the baker and the dough. And this is a parable. So yes, there is parables in the Old Testament. There's some I know in Judges. All right, Ephraim, he had mixed himself among the people. Ephraim is a cake, not turned. Strangers have devoured his strength, and he knoweth it not. Yea, gray hairs are here and there upon him, yet he knoweth not. And the pride of Israel testifieth to his face, and they have not turned to the Lord their God, nor seek him for all this. Ephraim also is like a silly dove without heart. They call to Egypt, they go to Assyria. I know some drivers like that. They put on their left-hand signal and then they turn right. Then they shall go. I will spread my net upon them. I will bring them down as the fowls of the heaven, and I will chastise them as their congregation hath heard. Woe unto them, for they have fled from me. Destruction unto them, because they have transgressed against me. Though I have redeemed them, yet they have spoken lies against me, and they have not cried unto me with their heart. When they howled upon their bed, they assembled themselves for the corn and wine, and they rebelled against me. Though I have bound and have strengthened their arms, yet do they imagine mischief against me. They return, but not to the Most High. They are like a deceitful bow. Their prince shall fall by the sword for the rage of their tongue. And this shall be their destruction in the land of Egypt. Number 8. Set the trumpet to thy mouth. He shall come as an eagle against the house of the Lord, because they have transgressed my covenant, and trespassed against my law. Israel shall cry unto me, My God, we know thee. Israel has cast off the thing that is good. The enemy shall pursue him. They have set up kings, but not by me. They have made princes, and I know it not. Of their silver and their gold have they made them idols, that they may be cut off. Thy calf, O Samaria, hath cast thee off. My anger is kindled against them. How long will it be ere they attend to innocence? For from Israel was it also. The workmen made it. Therefore it is not God. But the calf of Samaria shall be broken in pieces. For they have shown the wind, and they shall reap the wind, the whirlwind. It hath no silk or stalk. The bud shall yield no meal. If so be it yield, the stranger shall swallow it up. Israel swallowed up now. Shall they be among the Gentiles as a vessel within there's no pleasure? For they are gone up to Assyria. A wild ass alone by himself, Ephraim have hired lovers. Yea, though they have hired among the nation. Now will I gather them, and they shall sorrow a little for a burden of a king of princes. Because Ephraim have made many altars to sin, altars shall be unto him to sin. I have written to him the great thing of my law, but they are counted as a strange thing. They sacrifice flesh for the sacrifice of my offering and eat it, but the Lord accepted them not. Now will he remember their iniquity and visit their sin. They shall return to Egypt. For Israel has forgotten his maker, and buildeth them temples, and Judah have multiplied fenced cities. But I will send a fire upon his city, and it shall devour the palace thereof. Let's go back up here to 13. They sacrifice flesh for the sacrifice of my offering. I don't know, but I don't know if you know it or not, but sacrificing is still going on today. And unfortunately, most of them that are being sacrificed are little children. And it really breaks my heart to know this. Them little babies, they don't deserve it. If you look at, like, abortion, that's a sacrifice. They say that it is a sacrifice to their God and not to the living creator God. It is very, very sad at these sacrifices that I have been looking at, and I had to quit. I said, I can't take it no more. It's just too hard. All right, this is another small one. We'll read 9 tomorrow. A lot of hugs and kisses to you. How to donate to PayPal. You mash on Poor Man Sewing, and then you come up here, and you look for About, and you mash on About. And right here, you hit on Donate to Poor Man Sewing. It's people like you that help me out. And it is really appreciated. And I hope you many blessings in this hard times that we are fixing to go through. A lot of hugs and kisses to you.